Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Incredible Innovations. As you know, we bring new inventions, gadgets and discoveries, and tell you about its unique features and qualities. In this video, we are going to explore some amazing mech suits, where they have reached in their development cycles, and what is their possible use in our life. But, before doing that, if you have not subscribed to our channel, and you like this kind of content, please subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon, so you can get notification for our new video. So let's start this video! Mech suits or giant human exoskeletons have been around our lives in fiction, in movies. Movies like Matrix Revolution and Avatar brought them to the forefront of pop culture, and inventors all over the world started work on mech suits. The first bipedal mech suit came to existence as early as May 2005. The Landwalker was first bipedal mech suit in which human was able to sit and control its limb. Landwalker was only 3.4 meters high and weighed around 1,000 kilograms. Although it was a great leap in the direction of human-controlled mech suits, but it was a lazy machine. It had sliding walk action and was able to walk with a speed of 1.5 kilometers per hour. In August 2006, it was available in the market for only 36 million yen, or $345,000. But Landwalker was just a proof of concept, and never went further to another iteration. The only practical use Landwalker was serving, was a glorious fun toy for adult children. So Sakakibara-Kikai developed another mech suit. This time it was named Kidwalker. Kidwalker was only 1.6 meters high, and it had a price tag of $21,000. You can see Kidwalker as an amusement ride. In 2013, Kidwalker was upgraded to a new version. The new version had a drill and gripper. You can see it's functioning. It was all in amusement and toy territory for such inventions, until, in 2014, Jonathan Tippett proposed the idea of Prosthesis, and they have a clear goal in mind to start a race of human-piloted robots. A Korean company, Hankook Mirae Technology, also came up with their version of the mech suit. It was named Method 1. When we saw Method 1 the first time, it was just a mind-blowing sight. It is from science fiction movies. Designed by Vitaly Bulgarov, Method 1 is a 13 feet tall, walking robot mech suit with arms that can mimic the motions of a human pilot. On the other hand, Prosthesis is a 4,000 kilograms, 4 meter tall, Cromley steel frame monster that uses some 170 kilowatts worth of electric motors, hydraulics, springs, and suspension units to move its four giant legs individually in response to the movements of a pilot's limbs. Both mech suits have gone through the multiple iterations. Method series of mock suits have gone through to more iterations, until the last update from October 2018. But what we have seen, don't promise any improvement over the first version. All the changes we can see on videos which are available in the public domain shows, it is still connected with support cables on the roof. And all the celebrity pilots, who visit the facility, come and move their hands with help of controls. And then they walk a little with the robot on a path where the robot body is supported by cables. Not a single video or proof suggests that Method 3 can move independently, and its every limb is in perfect harmony with the pilot's control system. And we have not heard anything new from Method 1 team. It has become an amusement park toy for rich celebrities. Furrion Exobionics, on the other hand, made sure that suit is designed to act purely as an extension of the wearer's body. Within its range of motion, its outer legs do what your arms do, its inner legs do what your legs do. Thanks to a feedback loop, if it encounters an obstacle that stops one of its limbs from moving, you feel it in a tactile sense, because you simply can't move your limb any further. The parent company of Prosthesis has made it functional, and capable of so many scary things. enduring so many exhibitions, prostheses have displayed some humongous tasks only a true giant can perform. Prosthesis can lift a heavy truck. And climb on that trailer too, you can see Prosthesis in action when it is climbing on that truck. It has demonstrated its capability by walking over a concrete obstacle. It is not a destruction machine only, it can maneuver too, over obstacles in its path. Prosthesis looks quite menacing when it stands up from its resting position. Progress made since 2014 shows that the Prosthesis program has come a long way, and they are very close to his 14 years old vision of starting a mech race. For that, they need a lot of pilots. They have started the Prosthesis pilot program. In this pilot program, Jonathan Tippett, the inventor and director of this mock pilot program, will instruct you. You can be part of this program by paying $15. During this training, participants will be introduced drills and techniques which will help them to pilot this giant. This program will start with basic tasks, like standing up, playing football. And depending on the progress, you can go on to start destroying cars. But you have to take a car with you to destroy it. This is once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Selfie taken during your drills and training will be a moment to remember. In conclusion, Prosthesis is the only mech suit at the moment that is within reach of normal people, and they can dream of piloting it. Who knows, your participation in this hunt for the pilot can make you a pilot in the first mech race in the history of humanity. That's it for this video. Please let us know what do you think about this video, and let us know about suggestions in the comments section. Please subscribe to our channel and click on bell icons. Thanks for watching it.